making a new bracket, what I'm going to do is cut this off and mount this piece on this end to the car with the existing bolts. And I'm going to cut the actual leg with a different steel or aluminum, most likely it's going to be steel, and mount 3 bolts between 1, 2, 3, if I can fit another one here.
Okay, so what I did here is I traced it with a trace paper, scanned it to size, bring it to the computer to the exact size, and went ahead and traced as close as I can. You can see where I traced it, getting as close as I can. I'm not going to recut this wing, this bracket, this is not my bracket, but what I'm going to do is using the current mounting point, and this is where the mounting point is and where it was the 3 holes. I'm going to make the current mounting point to the new bracket. So I extrude it, it's a half inch. So I thought this would be a fun exercise for you guys to see while I'm doing this thing. So I'm going to copy this to another group. And like I said, I need this piece to be separate piece as I'm, so I don't have to keep mounting my bumper. I'm going to cut this. This piece is already made. So my entire goal right now doing it is to do this again. Let's get a good radius. So let's get a good radius right here. Most likely machine shop, this is what is going to happen. Most likely machine shop is going to cut straight and go back. Going to cut straight off this thing, cut straight off this, and they're going to sand that corner. So that corner, whatever radius they sand it in, may not be exact like this until they get finish it. But most likely that's where they're going to cut it. And that's why I'm telling them to cut. I'm going to cut that, get a step by step. So I'm going to cut this away. And now we only have...
So I'm going to make some 3/8 inch holes to put in here. That will be the bolt I want to use. A little bigger, but it's so beefy. 3 should hold a little better than 2. So center that just somewhere in the middle right now. Not really center, but drag an even distance using the bottom 3 holes, the mounting points. I don't think I can do the 4th one. It's too tight, too close. So let's give up that one. Punching 3 holes through, 3/8 inch. Make a little bigger. 3/8 inch and M10, it bolts about the same. So I'm going to make this big enough to fit those either bolts. 3/8. Looks like it fits pretty well. Make it a little bigger. Now I'm going to center this. So I'm trying to drag that side, the curved bumper side, to see if I can get away from the bumper a little bit so I can nail down the screw that's too thin over there. Undo it, and I'm going to make the center point and draw a line. Drag the center point to the middle of the line so they're evenly in within the space that I exposed. And looks like I need to do the top one too, get that centered. That's center in space, and after we cut that, print this out for the machine shop. Gotta make a center hole so they can drill correctly for the big bolts. So typically use a smaller drill first, and then you do a big drill, so that this will help them to drill the smaller bits, center drill, and do the big one. I think that's done.
3/8 inch, going to have a 3/8 inch bolt. So this hole is slightly bigger than 3/8 inch, so I still can punch through. After powder coat, I think it should be okay. Those are the 3 holes after we cut it. And this is the piece, the template. I'm going to double side tape onto it here. So when the machine shop cut this, they have the template and cut exactly where the hole is. And that's the center drill bit point to get this very accurate. Bracket is going to base on these 3 holes and go from there. So this has to be very accurate, this 3 holes. The back of the Corvette, that's where the bumper line is, and that's where the bolt goes, 3 bolts, and this will go away. And I will mimic this and mount the new, maybe extend it a little bigger, taller, mount the new Ivan's wing on there without this bracket, and it'll be a different type of bracket. It's cool. So I figure out the bolt and the nut I have to order. It'll be N10-9, that's for the extra strength. 1.5 thread, 35mm, and I'll show you how to reach that. So we will sandwich this piece, that's the middle part. middle part is this. That's half inch with 1/8 inch plate on each end for the actual brace. That's the nut I have to go into from the bolt. Okay, so that gives us 1 1/4. So basically a 30 millimeter bolt length will just shy by 9.6 millimeter, which is very little, 9.6 millimeter. Or I can order 35 millimeter and it will give me 3.2 millimeter, including the nut, which is perfect because the powder coat will be about a millimeter each on each end. So I'm per unit, half millimeter. So that will give me the most perfect, that will equal out to a flush nut and bolt on the one end. So that will be flush if I do 35 millimeter, that's in, will be including the powder coat. If it's just raw metal, it will stick out 3.2 millimeter, which is like this much, very little. But with a powder coat, this thing will just absorb out. There's that one. Little math from 1230 and I. And figure out the bolt and nut, and both gonna be black. Heat treated will be perfect.
Look at that, beautiful cut. Thanks to B&B Precision Welding and Cutting Machine Shop. Beautiful. Perfect fitment. Now, I only have to remove this once, put those guys in, then forever, I can switch the wing in and out. Beautiful piece, beautiful.